What's up, guys? It's Jake here from Chief Live Gaming. Today, a channel update for you guys. I haven't done these in a while, one of these in a while, and I think it's time. I've been having a influx, is that the right word? A lot of commission work lately, so I haven't had as much time for YouTube as I normally do, which is sad because I miss talking to you guys on YouTube. A lot of you guys that I'm subscribed to and that are subscribed to me, it's kind of like a little family that we've got going on YouTube. So doing my best to keep up. And again, if I don't comment, that doesn't mean I didn't watch some of your videos. It's just I don't always make it to my phone or to my laptop to write in a comment before it autoplays to the next video. So today, I want to just fill you guys in. Not a lot of content, again, being pushed out through the channel lately, and this is something that I can kind of lump a lot of different ideas I've been sort of having into one video for you guys, and kind of show you what I've been up to. So, first thing I want to do, let's just kind of meander over here and look at the painting bench while I sort of talk. So, I've got a couple things going on. Again, a lot of commission work coming in. We've got some Hero Forge. We've got an Atropos Knight. This is my Fire Raptor here, working on a bunch of miscellaneous things. Demon Prince or Bloodthirster conversion soon going on to eBay. Sadly, this was one of my Infernal Tetrad models that you guys might remember being covered in a video series. I've since decided that one of my collections needed to go, and Demons was the one, so this will be finished and hitting eBay soon. You may have noticed, keen eye among you, Kingdom Death minis hiding out back here, falling off of this base. Guys, short segue, if you've never heard of Kingdom Death, first of all, Google it, it's brilliant. If you ever get a chance to play Kingdom Death Monster, you need to not hesitate and play it. Do not hesitate at all. It is amazing. Any of you watching this video right now that are into Warhammer 40K, I can say without hesitation that you will probably love Kingdom Death and that you should give it a try. So I've been playing that with another couple, myself and my girlfriend, with another couple, doing campaigns for the past couple weekends, and my god, it's amazing. Guys, Kingdom Death, get in on it. It is incredible. So, in my last video update, what I want to do, guys, is kind of take you this way over to sort of the painting or the display case to kind of talk about a couple things. In my last news and updates video, I had talked about starting up 30K Mechanicum. Now, since then, I've run into a bit of a financial setback on that front. So instead, I realized that that was not going to be plausible, at least right now. Whether or not I do that in the future, we'll have to see. But as we make our way down to this shelf, you might see some Space Marines, which is weird. The only Space Marine army I own, really, or had owned until this point, was Grey Knights. But through my venture of trading away some of the demons that I wasn't going to sell, I have acquired Red Scorpions. So, Red Scorpions are a very cool chapter. At least I believe they're a very cool Loyalist chapter in the Space Marine or Astartes Legion. And they're actually one of the three that I was really considering starting for a Loyalist chapter. And you can see here that some of these guys actually have the Forge World Red Scorpion decals on them. Another keen-eyed observer on the painting bench may have noticed Severn Loth. So we have some, I've acquired a lot of Red Scorpions. This is not all of them. We'll get to the rest of them in a second. So that is going to kind of replace my new project, as it were. Instead of 30K Mechanicum, I'm building up the Red Scorpions as my sort of casual army. So here, let's get the glare out. You can see some of the power armored guys ready to be worked on, converted. About 30 scouts here ready to go. And then some more as we move this way. Got some orcs. And a few more of the Terminators ready to be scorpioned up. In addition to the Red Scorpions, I fell into a trade for some Eldar. Clayton, if you're watching this, bud, you have driven me to trade for some Eldar and start painting up my own collection as a standalone army, not just to ally with the Tau and make the dreaded Taudar, because who knows what that's going to be like in 8th, right? That might kind of... My competitive Taudar list may no longer function in 8th, so I may have kind of a standalone Tau army and then a standalone Eldar army. We'll just have to see. That looks quite impressive with the mirrors back there, doesn't it? It looks a lot bigger than it actually is. That's what she said. So, let's go this way, shall we? This is my sadness factory of project that I need to start. So this is what I've kind of inherited through trading in my local group. We have a lot of stuff that needed to be stripped, and I stripped to various success. As you can see, some of this stuff really was being more stubborn, and the paint, I mean, some of these models have to be over a decade old. Some of them stripped a little bit better than others, but we have various cool, mostly cool Forge World stuff on the Red Scorpions. A lot of iconography and a lot of special characters. Like if we move over here, this Land Raider, you can see, has the Red Scorpion front and side doors. If we look over here, and then I have a Whirlwind back in this corner as well that has the same doors. So as you can see, these are a project. They're going to need some work, but that's fine with me. I don't mind the extra work to strip or kind of fix up the models, because it makes me feel good, because I get usually a better deal that way and don't have to buy things, which as we mentioned in the beginning, helps out with the whole financial setback sort of situation. So that's great. We've got Eldar to work on, and we've got Red Scorpions to work on, which will kind of take the place of my 30K Mechanicum project, my new project that I've been kind of working towards for the future. Now, let's look at that. Another kind of interesting note. I am running a tournament locally. I'm getting together with... where did I put it? There it is. One of my friends, who's a very experienced tournament player. We are running a RTT round table tournament. I don't know what that actually stands for. It's not a GT. It's just a tournament in one of my local stores. And I've been making terrain, and I'm just going to take it down here. I should take you to the garage, maybe, and show you. Let's see. Oh, don't drop it. Okay, it's okay. So basically, we're making the terrain for all the tables. And we want the tables to be the exact same so that the tournament is balanced and the terrain is balanced. So we've made so far 12 full tables of terrain. So there will be two hills, two line of sight blocking runes, which, as you can see, are kind of boring. They're not really an exciting piece of terrain, which is good for tournament play, because you want things to be very clear, very defined, very crisp. That's why these things are built in such a boring way. It's very clear to understand when somebody's toe in cover here. It's very clear to understand when they are behind this wall. It's not kind of broken off or ruined up, so it's a little more ambiguous. It's very crisp, very clear, and that's something that I would definitely recommend for those of you looking to build competitively friendly 40K or wargaming terrain. So that's just another little update. Very quick
paint jobs, very quick construction. A lot of this is all foam board and MDF base, and this is just solid pink foam with some spackling and then quick spray paint and gloss varnish dumped everywhere, because this is going to get thrown around and beat up by my tournament players, so it needs to hold up well. And away we go. So that'll be fun. I'll probably update you guys on that as we hold the event and as things kind of pan out. Probably some clips during the tournament. I will be playing in it as well, since myself and my friend Cameron are both going to be TOs in that event. We're both going to play, and hopefully we can be available between one of us to make calls and kind of assist in that aspect of things. So, it'll be a lot of fun. That's the tournament terrain. What else can I update you guys on? Take a look at the mess here. This rag is so sad. I should probably wash that thing, huh? Yeah. If you guys have any questions at all, comments, always leave them down below. One of the main things I wanted to say in this video was leave your comments down below at what you guys want me to work on or focus on next, whether it be the Eldar or the Red Scorpions. What's your opinion, if you care, if you want to see one really badly, if you're a huge fan of one of the armies, let me know down below, and I'm going to kind of use that info moving forward as to what I want to sort of build and fix up first out of those two collections. I'm leaning towards Red Scorpions, mostly because they have a predefined paint scheme. I'm so bad at picking out paint schemes. It's probably going to take me forever to decide on a paint scheme for my Eldar, so just having one predefined, being Red Scorpions, being a Legion, I can just follow the paint scheme for the Legion markings and go with that. So, that's likely what I'm going to do. Damn you, Clayton. I'm just going to say it one more time. This is what you've done. You're an asshole. And I love you. So, back out here, we have Age of Sigmar. Which is another thing I've sort of fell into. One of my friends was like, hey, I really want to get into the Caradon Overlords, which were the steampunk dwarves. He said that he really wanted to get into those, and he had these Beastclaw Raiders that he's like, you know, I was originally going to do these, and then I saw the steampunk dwarves, so do you want to buy these for cheap, basically? He gave me a good deal on them, and Beastclaw Raiders was what I had originally thought would be really fun to try in Sigmar, so there we go. It kind of just all worked out. So I have four of these guys. I forgot the name. I played two games of Sigmar the other night. I really, really liked it. And that's a really good sign for 40K 8th edition, because it's going to be very similar from what I've heard. My little circle of knowledge. But Sigmar is amazing. You guys should also try it. We've got a little bit of Kingdom Death fan art fanboy going on over here. This is my Kingdom Death wall. Pin-up cards and the like. So what else can I update you guys on? It always works out that as soon as I close out the video, I will find something that I should have said in the video to update you guys on. I can show you these. I got these recently on the March sale. Some of the Kingdom Death minis. We got the 4th edition, number 4 collector's Bard. And these are all the hard plastic pinup models and things. I'm looking forward to getting those built up and painted to use in our campaigns. Let's see. Back over here to the painting bench. I guess it's a good place to mention Patreon again. So I don't want to be one of those channels that mentions Patreon like at the end of every video to kind of push patrons over there. But I might consider doing that, just because if you guys are watching through the entire video long enough to see me mention the Patreon thing, I figure it's not annoying to you. You like the channel, you enjoy the content, so it's not like it's not as much of a plug, and it's not going to get to you as much as me throwing it in the beginning. But Patreon, again, you guys all know that spiel. It's very helpful for artists like myself. Again, I do this full-time. I am a full-time commission painter, and it is tough. So making YouTube videos and finding kind of the time to do that can be a challenge depending on the month, depending on the commission kind of flow that I have going. So having you guys supporting me that do enjoy my artwork and my sort of work is something that gives me a little bit of a buffer and allows me to continue to do more YouTube content or to focus more on the YouTube content and kind of sneak more videos in here and there and still pay my bills and keep the paint flowing and keep the lights on. So that's there down in the description for those of you that are interested. Again, I don't want to push it too much, but it is there for those of you that might want to consider it. So I think I've said all I wanted to say, guys. We talked about Sigmar, we talked about the new 40K collections, we talked about Kingdom Death, the tournament. That's about it. So again, I just want to thank you guys very much for continuing to support myself, support the channel. Let's do a forward-facing closeout here. Look at that transition. Any other content that you want to see in the channel that I'm not including, please leave a comment down below in the comment box there. If there's anything that you want to see that I'm not really covering, live content is something that I wish I had the time to do, and I could probably make the time for if there was enough interest, but it's more of a learning thing and more of a time commitment. I have to actually sit in one spot for a couple hours to stream, which is something that it has been a challenge. So if you really want to see live content, please let me know and I can try to make that more of a thing. Otherwise, I want to just mainly kind of focus on getting more YouTube videos out on a regular basis. So 17 minutes, I think that's long enough for you guys to listen to me talk. Thanks a lot for watching. I will see you guys in the next video. I hope you're having a great day. Bye now.